all and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to share the recipe of a keto dal makhani with you. So dal makhani is a dal which is made from urad dal. It's the black lentils and they have that almost gooey texture to it. It makes a lovely creamy base, and to that we add a lot of cream and butter, and that's what the preparation is. So if not for the dal, the recipe is a perfect keto recipe. So we are going to substitute the dal for buchananya or chiroli or chironji seeds, and we are going to make this preparation.
So let me show you the packet of the buchananya. These are these tiny seeds which almost taste like almonds. And if you don't have these, you could definitely substitute it for some other seeds like melon seeds or so, which will also taste very similar. I like these because they, after soaking, look almost like the black dal, and they have that kind of a texture to a certain extent.
So let me show you what it looks like
after cooking.
This is the chironji seeds. I have soaked them overnight and boiled them in a pressure cooker with two green chilies. So they look very similar to dal or the black dal that we are talking about, and they're going to work out really well. So let me set this aside and start the recipe. So what I need here is I'm going to take two small sized tomatoes and I'm going to blend them to make a puree. And I will also start my gas and heat my pot and get back to you. So I have these almost unripe tomatoes, and you want actually slightly riper ones, but this is what I have today. I'm going to cut the stem off because they are so raw. I'm going to put them in my jar, blend them. Here we have our puree. You can also use the store-bought puree, that has a better color. But we are going to fry this and reduce it, and that will kind of thicken it and also give it a deeper color. So this is a pot to which I'm adding about 2 tablespoons of ghee and some cumin seeds, so about half a teaspoon. I don't like them getting brown. They could get bitter a little bit, so you want to avoid doing that. And this is some ginger garlic, taking about 2 teaspoons. So you want to reduce this a little bit. So our gravy is ready, and before we add our buchananya or the dal, I want to remind you guys to click the like button, subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell if you still haven't done all of this. And let's watch the rest of the recipe then. So you can see that our tomatoes have cooked down. You want the oil to kind of separate. I hope you can see on the edges when the oil separates from the tomatoes. This is the right point to add our dry spices. So I'm going to add a teaspoon of red chili powder. This is Kashmiri red chili powder. And this is half a teaspoon of turmeric. I'm using Kashmiri red chili powder because it gives a nice color to this dish. And you want the slight redness from that. And now we are going to add the buchananya along with the water. Give this a stir, and I've added some salt while cooking it, so I'm going to add a little more just for the tomatoes, and we are going to let this boil for about 5 minutes, and it'll get a little thicker, and then we are going to add some kasuri methi and cream. Keep an eye on this. I'm going to cover it and keep it on a low gas. So I think it's been boiling for 7 minutes now. We are going to add the rest of the things. This is a pot of butter. I'm just keeping it here so it heats up a little bit and melts so I can get it out. So our dal is ready. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this and blend it in the blender because I want that creamy consistency that I was talking about. So just a little bit. We're going to leave some in the pot itself. So here is the paste I made. Look how beautiful it looks. So this is kasuri methi. We're going to crush it a little bit and sort of add it. Not too much because you don't want it getting bitter. And a little bit of cream. It's about a teaspoon and a half. And the butter. Look at it. It's a silver pot and it melts the butter easily.
and our dish is ready. We will plate it now and eat it with some keto roti.
I hope you guys enjoyed watching the video and will give this recipe a try. If you do, let me know in the comments section how it turned out for you. There's also information about all the gadgets and ingredients that I use in my kitchen. So I have left a link to all of that in the description section. So check that out. Everything is on my website. So thanks for watching. Bye.